Asmat Guru Bhyo Namaha. Asmat Sarva Guru Bhyo Namaha. Asmat Parama Guru Bhyo Namaha. Alva Thiruvadigale Sharanam. Imberumana Thiruvadigale Sharanam. Sirandu Dopul Thiruvengada Modiyan Thiruvadigale Sharanam. Siman Venkadanatharya Kavidhar Kikakesari. Vedantacharya Varyome Sannidattam Sadakhrithi. Sudharma Jnana Vairagya Sadhya Bhaktyega Kocharaha Narayana Param Brahma Gita Sastre Samiridaha. We are continuing on the TIkA. TIkA means commentary, annotation, small brief. So we take any of the shloka or pasuram, try to explain that one within it's not possible, 15 to 20 minutes, you know. So we are continuing on the Bhagavad Gita from the last class. Today we are going to learn about Bhakti Yoga. We discussed enormously Pravati Yoga in the Srimad Ragasyatra Saram. But we have to understand a little bit what they really do. So that is explained mainly in the Sri Bhashyam. It is also explained in Gita Bhashyam. So we try to take at a cursory look. Now we are not going to do any of those things. We are all done with this Prabhati. But even somebody tries Bhakti Yoga, how difficult it is, we have to understand. So we had to get some kind of a cursory look. Last episode we saw that we said Bhagavad Gita is 666, 3-6 of them. The first six chapters basically, predominantly in all the chapters, Karma Yogam, Jnana Yogam, Bhakti Yogam, Prabhati, all of them are mentioned. It is not completely one is mentioned, others are void. First six mainly Karma Jnana. 7 to 12 basically, second Shadgam basically is Bhakti Yogam predominantly. So, and we saw the summary of that. What did we see on that one? Krishna, Bhagavan, Parabrahmam addressing Arjuna. And he says, what is the true nature of me? How do you understand that one? And then Maya or Prakriti. Maya means Prakriti because that blinds you. Maya, the screen blinds the true Swarubam of you, the true Swarubam of me. You don't understand that one. How we get into that one? Because you did Pavam continuously from several Janmas. How do you get after that one? You do the Sharanagari to me. So Bhakti can be in many different ways. There are four different Bhaktas are there. Among them, four types. Among them, the Jnani is the most I love. That's what Krishna was said. This is what we saw in the last class. Today, we're going to see more details. In this one, some details of the Bhakti Yoga. We had many, many births. All of us, continuously, we are going through. Do we remember any of the previous birth? We don't remember any of the previous birth. Our karma, what we are having, conceal Purva Janma Vasane, Purva Janma Nyabagam, Purva Janma, what we have done, the samskaram we don't. We don't remember anything from last Janma or any of the previous Janmas. But there are some people we heard in all our scripts are saying, like Vidura, Jadabharada, they know whatever happened. They have Janmantara Jnanam. They knew what happened previously. That is important for Bhakti Yoga. First thing you have to understand, Bhakti Yoga ke Janmantara Jnabhagam. Why? Prabhati you do in this Janma. Edat Dega Vasanema, at the end it's all done. But Bhakti is a continuous chain coming from so many of them. So, where you left off, there you have to continue. So, for that you have to know what happened in the previously. So, Bhakti Yogis, all of them would know what they did in the previous Janma. That is the first thing we have to understand. And beautifully, Imbirvanar explains this one in Gita Bhashyam. Suprabhutva, that is what he says. Prabhutva. What it means, the person who sleeps, when he wakes up, he knows what happened before he went to sleep. Same thing. So, Bhakti Yogam, where you left off, that's where you have to continue. Yoga Prashtan, that is what he calls. Yoga Prashtan, the one who does the Yogam, remembers the Yogam from the previous Janma. Where did he slip? That is where he continues. He slipped maybe for different reasons. Maybe he died. He slipped. Or suddenly some rishi found a girl. So he went out of the tapas, went to somewhere else. So you have to know where you left off, so you continue. So this is like a bank account. You continue to put there. So you put it for 3 months, you stopped. And then you put something, so the bank man knows he adds to that one, similarly. So that is how you have to do the Bhakti Yoga, first thing. How long you have to do this one? In Sri Bhashyam we studied, aprayanat. That means, until the last journey. So you have millions of births coming one after another, and that is the last in the Bhakti Yoga. From there, you're going to go to the Archiradi Margam, going to the Moksham. Until then, you have to do this one. So Krishna says, this is the Bhakti Yogi in the 6th chapter at the end. So we have to do the Sangadi, connecting to that one. And he says, Yogi is very superior than the Tapasvi. Very beautifully he says, the person who does the Bhakti Yogam compared to the Tapasvi, the Mahatmyam of the Bhakti Yogam is greater than the Tapas. And we know that one, the Mahatmyam of Prabhati is a trillion times superior than any of the Bhakti Yogam. So now we are talking Bhakti Yogam. So the Bhakti Yogam Pandaram is a Tapasvi, is a Jnani, is a Karmi, is everything. But Tapasvi and Krishna distinguishes, Bhakti Yogam does everything for the purpose of Bhagavan. Tapasvi, he does that one for some kind of a purpose, selfish reasons and everything. So, amongst the yogis, we can talk about Karma Yogi, Bhakti Yogi, Jnana Yogi, Ashtanga Yogi, all of them you take away. All of them, Bhakti Yogi is the highest one. And he says, that is what I love. Krishna loves Bhakti. The reason I bring that one, because for Prabhati also Bhakti is there. That is the reason I try to bring that one. In Srimad Bhagavatam, we study Uddhava Gita. Bhagavata Mahapurana, everybody heard about this Ekadesi Mahatmyam, Ambarishan. At the end, Ambarishan, what happened is Durvasar, he puts this chakram and everything. Finally, Bhagavan says, Bhagavan means Krishna. So Bhagavan says over here, I am Bhakta Paradhinohi Aswadantra Ivadvija Sadhvir Krasta Hridayo Bhaktir Bhakta Janapriyaha. Bhagavan's word, Aham Bhakta Paradhino Bhaktas Deha Swadantram. I am becoming dependent on him. Aswadantra, he Aswadantra, indeed. I don't have any. They tied me. Kaninun Shrittaminal, Katunna Pandya Purumay and Mari. Ivad Vijay. Hey, Durvasa Vangarishi Brahmanare, I'm telling this one. And in addition, he says, Sadhubi, pure devotee. Sadhubi means completely free of material things. Only Bhagavan you have to think. And Grastha Hridaya, they are, my heart is controlled by them. What I tell, what I move, what I want, everything, this sadhu is controlling me. That is what he says. Bhakti, because Bhakta Janapriya, this one goes not only to the devotees, but the devotee's devotee. He says, just like we tell Shatrughunan is going to Bharatan, Bharatan is to Rama, Bhagavan is saying like that. So that is the reason, even if you are a Pabi, go and live under the shade of a good Mahan, Bhagavan gives you everything. That is why you go to the Acharya's place and prostrate that one, even though you have done all the akramam, because Acharya's aura is there, that protects you. Very nicely Krishna says like that one, I am not independent. I sit only with the course of their heart. Whatever they say, that is in my heart. And completely, who are those people? Completely void of material things. Sadhu, when we say like that one, in general Krishna mentions, think only about Bhagavan. This was told by Bhagavan to Durvasa Maharishi. We point out here, same Krishna, we're going to see everywhere. So when you go into the Bhagavatam, something we tell. When you go to Uddhava Gita, we tell. When you go into the Bhagavad Gita, we tell. What Krishna told, that is what everybody copied. So that is what we are looking. And he says, another word, Anya Abhilashada Sunya. Other desires, you should be zero. Then only it's called pure bhakti. So, and this greatness of bhakti, he says that one, bhakti, the greatness is, everybody does bhakti. Bhakti yogi does that one, he uses as a sadhanam, as a means to reach the Bhagavan. For us, Prabhanas, that bhakti is a sadhyam. Why you are doing bhakti? That is the happiness. See, the person, before marriage, he writes everything to that girl. Nice poetry, brings nice flowers, everything. Why? Because he wants to get married. That is the reason. Once you got married, she is your property. And then what you can do? You can enjoy or take her to the movie, or you can go and have a nice dinner or anything, or you don't have to do anything. Why are you doing? Not for the marriage, it is over. Because that is the phalan. Okay? So until then, the affection, what it is, the love what you are pouring is for the purpose. And after that, the purpose is done, it is the enjoyment. Okay? So that is what he says. For us, it's a sadhyam. So now with that one, we go into the 7th chapter. Little bit understand that one. So Krishna is going to tell Bhakti Yogam. Arjuna Krishna Samvadam. Basically, discussion, communication, Arjuna is asking. Krishna, you told in the last chapter about the Shraddhai. One should have that much of concentration, attention, uni-mind into Bhakti. Having a faith, loyal, reverence in everything. Devotion is superior. You said that one. I want to think of you, Krishna. I understand that. But if I want to think of you, who are you? I have to know about you to think about that. Meditate on what? What should I think? Tell me about you. You are the Ubhasyan, is the target. See, we know that one. If a person loves a girl, let's assume, I bring thee all these things, worldly things also. Because Sharira Vivagam, Atma Vivagam. So the boy, what he does? He has a picture of the girl, or he has got her a sari, or he has got the kerchief from her, or something he touched, or some person. So even Tirukudanandan used to say, he doesn't say lover, wife. See, he keeps on looking at the bus. What is it? Oh, this bus goes to my wife, her parents' place. That mamiyar vittukku poda. And the bus paathiye sandosham nikkran nayo. There has to be some kind of a thing for you to do. So, Krishna, I want to have a upasyan. You are the target. How would I pray, Krishna? And all ours is idol worship. Because that is your mind will go into that one. So he is asking. And remember in Ragasatra Sara, we said, Pirumalukku rendu vidhama irukku. Onnu vandu Subhashrema irukkakoodi. Subhamam irukkakoodi. Divyatma Swarubam. Divya Mangala Vigraham. Atma Swarubam Aridagayale. We cannot do. But what we are talking here? We are talking about Bhakti Yogam. Atma Swarubam, that's what it has to come. For us, Divya Mangala Vigraham. Kovil irukka Pirumal. Because we are all cheap souls. We are not doing that kind of a bhakti for sadhana. Okay? Coming back here. So, all this what we are telling here, Krishna, tell about you, is asking. Krishna is going to tell. This is exactly in Sribhashyam. So, what you study over here runs in parallel to Sribhashyam, because Sribhashyam talks about Bhakti Yogam. How do you see the Bhagavan's Swarubam? Forget about Divya Mangala Vigraham. There is no Utsav Murthy, no Salagramam. We are going to do something inconceivable. That is how we have to see the Perumal. So, we need to know about the Bhakti Yoga, because let me tell you an example. This runs in parallel to Bhakti Yoga, as Sribhashyam I said. Why we need to know the Bhakti Yoga? We do Bhakti also. Why we have to know Bhakti Yoga? We are all Prabhanas. We also do the same thing like them, but without any handcuff. So let's assume we go to from here to some country, let's say England. When we go, after the plane is landed, we go through immigration, we go through customs, we do all those paper checking and everything. Okay? But let's say Trump is walking. When Trump is walking, does he have to show his passport? No. He just walks over there. So, we are like the Trump. So, when we go any place, when we do anything, we do because Bhagavan has given a free license for you to go and enjoy him. So, we don't have to worry about it. I do bhakti, one day I do aradhanam, next 5 days I don't do. One day I buy the flowers, next day I don't buy flowers. One day I wake up at 8 o'clock, one day I wake up at 3 a.m. Do whatever you want. It is your property. And that is not any prerequisite to enjoy Bhagavan or anything. It's all done already on the contract and the prabhati. Bhakti yogi it is not. He is handcuffed. Every day he has to do like that one. A prayanat until he gets that one. See, understand? So, we also do bhakti, they also do. That is why when we walk that one, you remember there is a place for crew and first class in the immigration. These guys are walking without showing anything. And you see millions of crowd over there. Nindum kurigiyum irukkum, Desian says. Ours is a short path. Theirs is a long path. So, to understand bhakti yoga, we understand, oh, we would have done like that one. Thank God we went to prabhati. At least what they do, 1 trillion we should do. That is what we have been. Krishna said, Arjuna, I'll tell you. You want to think about me, I tell you, who am I? That is what the first thing is saying. Who am I? You need to think of me, contemplate about me. First, before you know what I am, how you have to think, I am telling you. Maya sakta mana. Mayi asakta mana, he says. Asakta means fond of, directed towards, very enthusiastically following, attached strongly. So with that mind attached, maya sakta mana, mayi asakta mana. That's the first Krishna says. This is how you have to think, very closely attached. And then matashraya, mat ashraya, do surrender to me. Okay? How beautifully he says, you mayi asakta mana, attach fondly to me, do the surrender to me. Now you jump into Uddhava Gita. Tum tu sarvam parityachya snegam swajana bandushu maya vesya mana samyak mayi avesya mana samyak. Krishna, how beautifully he puts that on. That is what I want to bring. Bhagavad Gita first solacha maya sakta mana, put your mind into me. Do the sanagadi, put your mind to me. Rendu bookend. So, sanagadi in between. Here you do that one as a bhakti yoga. Here you do as a prabhati yoga. No difference. Same Krishna tells the same thing. Okay. Here when you avesa. Avesa means taking possession of. Seizure of that. Why you do that one? That guy may do, may not do that one. Because bhakti yogi, he may wait. He is not married. He can do anytime. But you, your property is Bhagavan. You enjoy him. You do the alangaram. You do the tirumanjanam, everything. Why you do that one? Because you possess him. Seizure. Mayi haveshya. So, ennude sundam. Abdini, you take that one and you do that. So, the comparison is, same Krishna, at the start of the bhakti yogam to Arjuna, he says that one, maya sakta mana. Same Krishna, at the start of the post-prabhati, advised Uddhava, says the same thing. But there, you do because you are afraid. You want to do. You want to have reverence. Here you do. Hey, that's my wife. That's, I want the property. That's my Bhagavan. So you have the right to do that one. So how beautifully he connects Krishna. Both of them, similar words he uses. But both of them are bhakti. So everywhere you say, love the Bhagavan. The means and the rewards are the same. Inga solra bhakti, Bhagavad Gita, it is bhakti yogam. Uddhava Gita solra bhakti is the prabhati kapram, post prabhati, anubhavam or prapti. So whether it's the means or the rewards, you got only one. Bhagavan is the means, he is the, ends of that one. So in this one, what we, Krishna was basically telling, what I wanted to tell in this lecture, whether you are a bhakti yogi or prabhati yogi, no difference. Bhakti you have to do. That is why they have to do bhakti to attract Bhagavan. You have to do bhakti to enjoy him. So to attract, if he fails, that's a problem. The enjoyment, if you fail, no problem. Still it's your wife. In this case, it's our husband. So very nicely Krishna brings that one. Understand. First level he tells, this is how you have to approach me. Now I'm going to tell you who am I. So we'll do in the next class. Kavidharkiga Simmaya Kalyana Gunashalini Srimade Venkatesaya Vedanta Gurave Namaha Srimade Nihamanta Mahadeshigaya Namaha.